Alrighty guys, several things to report on today. We had a 6.6 that they downgraded to a 6.5 in Costa Rica, that same place, pretty close to the exact same epicenter as that 7.1 or 7.2 or whatever that was a little while back. I believe back in September. Anyway, 6.5 magnitude earthquake, and we'll take a look at that real quick. One thing about it, guys, is that you're looking at 20 kilometers. It's very shallow, so it's been felt pretty far away. Let's take another look at something. Okay, over here on Google Earth, right here is the epicenter, 6.6 in Costa Rica. Give you an idea where it's at. There's water over here. 6.5 over here. So there is buildings in the area, there's housing in the area. And this one struck right over farmland, but there's housing all throughout this road here. A little town there. So just to give you an idea, guys. And then it is on land, so there's probably not any kind of tsunami. I'm pretty sure there's no tsunami. And anyway, the reports are that it's been felt as far away as Nicaragua. So, very shallow, guys. Very shallow earthquake. A lot shallower than that 7.1. So this may have done a lot more damage. So heads up on that. For those of that have family members down that area or whatever, 6.5 and 6.6. So heads up on that. Let's move on here. As far as the weather, you still got the remnants of Rafael getting ready to go into Spain, Europe area here. We've got this tropical cyclone going on over near Indonesia, coming right through it, flooding that area out. And then we got this one down here, which at this point looks like it's going to go straight through Cuba. So heads up Cuba for flooding, and then straight through the Bahamas, pretty much taking a fairly direct northerly trek. So heads up if you live in the path of this thing, and also heads up Florida, you'll probably get the outer bands off of it at the very least, probably some wind, that kind of, maybe some surge, I don't know, but depends on how close it gets to you guys. But it should be going on a pretty much north track, and you're kind of looking at an angle here, so north is kind of at an angle on this map. But it's going to be headed north, straight through Cuba, straight through the Bahamas area. So heads up in those areas. And then the question is it going to travel right along the edge of the coast, get sucked up into one of these low pressure systems, or is it going to get out into the Atlantic Ocean? Looking over here on the other map, you can see the low pressure sitting down in here, and then you've got a bit of a high pressure right in this area, and then you got low pressure here. So low pressure going counterclockwise is trying to force it north. You've got the high pressure, which is going to kind of, it's going to be pressing against it like a buffer. So it's either going to go pretty much northerly and follow the coastline, which means everybody may get outer bands off the storm, or it may hit the coast. But the most likely scenario is that it's going to come into the Bahamas and then start to head north and east, being pulled on by the low pressure system. But we'll have to wait and see as time goes forward on that. So heads up if you live in those areas, Cuba, Florida, the Bahama area. One last thing I want to cover over here on Idaho Picker. He's been talking about this for a while, and he's been very suspect about what was going on in this general area right here. This is the sinkhole, or now what is slowly becoming known as the Bayou Corn Lake. Anyways, he's been talking about this for quite a while now. Again, this is Idaho Picker. I'll put his link down below the video here if you want to go check him out, if you want to subscribe, or whatever you want to do on that. Anyways, right down here, he's been talking about this area right here. He's been very concerned about it, and a lot of evidence showing that it's slowly beginning to collapse in and all these kind of things. Well, with this latest image, and I'm not sure where he picked this up at, but with this latest image here, you can clearly see now that this is all the way, the earth is literally cracking now, all the way from the Bayou Corn Lake, or Sinkhole Lake, all the way down in this general direction, which is going directly toward, as Idaho Picker points out here, it's going directly toward that butane well. If it's not already there, guys, it's getting within football fields of that butane well. Now, the butane well gives in at all, if it's breached at all, there's a lot of butane in that well, guys. A lot of butane. And all it would take is a lightning storm. But also, even apart from an explosion, if it starts venting out its butane, apart from an explosion, say there's no spark, no ignition source, the illnesses, the sicknesses, the diseases, the things that are going to come off of this, the health problems, guys, this is becoming more and more serious by the day. As I've said, if you live in this general area, don't worry about returning, guys. Move on with your life. Move. Get out of that area. Those of you guys that live in that general area but haven't been evacuated, start working on getting out of that state. Start looking for another job somewhere else. Start applying. Start doing what you got to do to get out of this general area. Okay? This is a serious, serious situation, guys, and it is continuing to get worse and worse every day. Okay, now, say this butane well is compromised, and I'm not saying it's going to get compromised, I'm just pointing out what Idaho Picker has already pointed out, that where this earth is literally cracking and filling up with water is headed exactly in the direction, which is just right down here. This is that manufacturing plant, so directly straight this way is the butane well, and it's just a few football fields away. So, if it continues to crack in that direction, eventually that will get compromised. Okay, so this is a very serious situation. Homeland Security, or was it Homeland Security? I don't remember who it was. Excuse me. Guys, go watch this video. Idaho Picker covers the new FEMA trains that got the shackles in the three-story building train cars. He covers all that stuff, things I haven't actually had the opportunity yet to get to talking about. He does cover it in this video, so if you want to know more about that, go check it out. Check this video out. And I would actually recommend subscribing to him, but that's y'all's decision. You do what you want with it. This situation is getting worse. Here's my point, guys. Once the butane starts leaking, if it does, and I'm not saying it's going to, but if this crack continues to move this direction and eventually hits that butane well, then you have an extremely bad situation. All it would take is a spark, and you got a detonation like we've not seen, probably ever. Okay? But say that there is no ignition, no spark, no thunderstorms, no nothing comes through the area, no one lights a cigarette, whatever. Okay? Say all that's okay. The health problems are going to be serious if you live in the area or in the area in the direction of the wind. If you ever want to know what the wind's doing, this would be a great website for you guys to go check out. If you ever want to know, this gives you the speed. Right here is the graph. This is the speed chart. And then this is the actual current live wind that's going on right now. So currently, you know, right now you've got basically wind going toward, coming from the east, headed toward the west, and kind of to the northwest in the Louisiana area. So that's the general direction that the butane would begin to move. And the health problems and the health risks associated would go with it. Okay, so you'd have to monitor this map if something were to go down, and if that well does, if it's not already been compromised, if it does end up failing, guys, you'll need to know which way the wind's going and get out of that area, just for your health reasons. He also goes into details about where the money's at and what's going on and how everybody gets paid and how the parish has been getting paid. So again, I would go check out that video if I were you guys. So say we don't get a spark, okay, say everybody gets out of the area, so there's no health problems, everybody evacuates, everybody's out of the area, nobody gets any kind of health problems. There's one more problem, guys. That's butane. That means that that ground, that entire well, which is under pressure, butane, you know, pressure capped off, it's a well, it's a salt dome that's been cleaned out and filled in with butane. Once it escapes, you got a very, very big hole in the ground. Okay, so you've got a whole new sinkhole in the works. And it's probably going to fill with salt water. It's probably going to come in from the other direction. Plus come in from the last, the new Bayou Corn Lake, the Bayou Corn Sinkhole. So it would come in from this way, and it would probably fill up from the ground up as well. And it may also fill up with the oil and all the other things that are going on. So, anyways, guys, I'm going to go ahead and get off of here. There's a lot going on, things that you really need to be keeping up with, especially if you live in Louisiana, guys. We have a very, very serious situation going on in Louisiana. We're monitoring the elections to determine whether or not what we saw on the TV, we have a record of it, I have it on video, we're going to determine whether or not what we saw on TV ends up being those numbers or not, okay? If it ends up being those numbers, it's unquestionable whether or not the presidential election is rigged or not, okay? But if it doesn't end up being those numbers, then it's all good. Carry on, carry forward. All we're doing is keeping a record of it just in case, okay? But we've got earthquakes, guys, and you need to be on the heads up with the earthquakes. Okay, 6.5 magnitude at a very shallow depth is destructive. Okay, very destructive. Now, if it was a 6.5 and very deep, it wouldn't do nearly the damage. So I'm not exactly sure what's going on. From what I've heard, the clinics and hospitals are up and running. They weren't hurt in any way. But there is damage. There is destruction going on down there. So, guys, put your prayers out to these people as well. So, heads up on the earthquakes, guys. As you know, there's a perpetual heads up around the entirety of the Pacific Ocean from now until the end of this age. Okay? Permanent, guys. You're going to get sixes and sevens off and on, and even eights and nines off and on from here to the end. It's not going to change, okay? We watched this thing grow. We watched it when there was very few earthquakes, and we watched it expand literally throughout the planet. Diverse places is what the word said. The word diverse, when you look it up, it means throughout the planet. And great earthquakes at that. One passage says diverse places, the other one says great earthquakes. One says earthquakes, the other one says great earthquakes. Makes it more specific. So there will be eights, there will be nines, off and on. But you will have, from here on out, on a pretty consistent basis, you will always have mid-fives and then sixes and sevens on a pretty consistent basis throughout the entirety of the Pacific. Any body of water or land touching the Pacific Ocean is under a perpetual, never-ending, heads up until the end of the age. Okay? It's very simple. Heads up for earthquakes, above-ground volcanoes, and submarine volcanoes, or below-the-water volcanoes. That's what a submarine volcano is, if you don't know. Okay? Perpetual. And again, this 6.5 struck on water touching Pacific Ocean. Same thing here, 6.0 touching the Pacific Ocean. It's going to be the same thing over and over again, guys, so just perpetual heads up. Heads up on the tropical storm turning into basically a hurricane just before hitting the Bahamas and the Cuba area, so heads up down there. Heads up Florida in case it gets a little bit closer to you than what I think it will, but I still think you're going to get the bands off of it, so be paying attention as it comes through. And guys, be praying for those people down there in Louisiana that no matter what happens, everybody's okay. Okay? It doesn't matter what happens as long as the people are okay. Let the people who are corrupt, evil, and wicked go down with it if they're involved with this catastrophe. And that's literally what this is. This is unbelievable what we're witnessing. In slow motion, what's happening in Louisiana. It's unbelievable. Love you guys. Get in the Word, stay in the Word, and get the Word in you. It's the most important thing you can possibly do. Shalom to all.